and ready to match the stars. George Kennedy, Rex Summer, Charles Nelson Reiner, Donna Mill, Richard Dawson, and Patty Dawson as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reiner.
Let's see, I get all the business out of the way. The Blue Knight. Is there anything you want to plug?
No.
All reruns now.
All reruns?
Yeah.
Well, we'd be glad to mention them if you'd like.
Oh, a movie that we call Beyond the Bermuda Triangle.
All right. How about that? That's an interesting subject, yes. Anything you want to plug?
Belle of Amherst.
The Belle of Amherst, yes.
With Miss Julie Harris.
Starring Julie Harris. It's about Emily Dickinson. Directed by Charles Nelson Reilly. And it's a hit.
We congratulate you, Charles.
Now, let's get on to Rory DeMere and Robbie Zollers over here. How you feel?
Good.
How much money do you want?
$1,200.
$1,200. What are you going to do with that?
I don't know. Probably move back to Los Angeles.
All right. We will encourage that effort. And Robbie, you've had your first round question. You match one of our celebrities, and we'll continue with this game with her first round question, Rory's that is, in a moment or so. But right now, this is for you. Here we go. All right. Rory, ready? Yes. This is your first round question. It reads as follows. Now, hear this. They just published the world's thinnest book. It's called...
The Wit and Wisdom.
No, it's called My Accomplishments in Office. It's written by... Blank. You got it. The world's thinnest book has just been published. It's called My Accomplishments in Office, and it's written by... And it's up to you to fill in the blank. Well, yes, I agree. There's always more than one good answer to our responses, but there's one especially appropriate one, I think, in this case, and we'll find out. All right. Here we go. Rory DeMere, they just published the world's thinnest book. It's called My Accomplishments in Office. It's written by...
Richard Nixon.
She said it with a smile on her face.
I got to keep getting these rights. I'm going to get a hug out of
that's here. Right. Yeah. There's one for Rory. Brett, what do you say?
Remember when you asked Rory what she was going to do with the money?
Yeah.
Charles muttered under his breath, she's going to get her teeth fixed.
That's a real touch of humor because she has the most perfect teeth since the history of human civilization. Just want to make sure everybody understood that.
I think this is a match. I just couldn't remember that man's last name. I said, Mr. Richard, what's his name?
Yes. Yes.
Dickie Boo Nixon.
Dickie Boo Nixon. The world's thinnest book called My Accomplishments in Office, written by Richard Nixon, according to Rory.
Yeah. Same thing.
Tricky Dickie. All right. Richard.
Remember the words of Gerald Ford, who said, pardon?
What do you say?
The Private Citizen Nixon.
Private Citizen Nixon. That's six for you. You struck pay dirt with that one, didn't you?
Sure
okay,
did.
Now let's go to round two here and ask Robbie to make her selection.
I'll take B.
You want B. Now, Robbie, you've got to match the five remaining celebrities with this to achieve a tie. Hey, did you hear what happened in Henry's bathroom? Oh. Well, let me tell you about it. The Tidy Bowl man climbed out of the tank and Henry blanked on him. You don't play, George. A couple of good choices here.
The Tidy Bowl man... Wait a minute. The Tidy Bowl man climbed out of the tank.
Beautiful.
There are two.
There, Henry. Do Tidy Bowl Man questions here. Well, it could be Henry, it could be. In Henry's bathroom, the Tidy Bowl Man climbed out of the tank and Henry blanked on him. All right, Robbie's thinking about it. We'll get over her in a second or so. Okay, Robbie. Robbie, did you hear what happened in Henry's bathroom? The Tidy Bowl Man climbed out of the tank and Henry blanked on him.
Tinkle.
You're blushing.
What did she say, sweetheart?
She said he tinkled on him.
Oh, good gravy, Marie. If you believe in fairies, tinkle on
the lip. Charles?
He made wet on him.
So at this moment, the score is 6-3. You've got to match the remaining celebrities in the lower tier to achieve that tie. Donna?
I wouldn't stop it.
Oh, there's another one. Now 6-4. Richard?
Richard, I've got to go.
Yeah, no, you better stick around. Just show us your answer before you go.
I was thinking of a different thing entirely. I said he sat on it.
He sat on it! Here we go again. All right, hang around here now. While we say goodbye, you missed it by one because she had whizzed on it, too. Oh. So the score really ended up 6-5. Listen, it was a pleasure meeting you, my dear.
Nice meeting you.
We've got some gifts for you together with our thanks for being here on Match Game 76. Goodbye, Robbie. Okay. Now, Rory, you picked up another $100. You got $1,300 at this moment, and you're going to have another go at the Big Apple here, the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $5,000. Shall we go right on to it?
Sure.
Hey, listen, you know, it may not appear that way to you in the control booth, but there's a dark spot over here.
It does.
Okay, thank you. I thought I was going out of my mind.
You are.
That's enough. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Chest blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the middle one, it's $250, the bottom $100. Now, let's see your choice this time.
Richard.
Just a song at twilight.
Just a song.
Just a song at twilight when the lights are low. I'm going to say chest x-rays.
Chest x-rays.
That's a business I'm going into very soon.
All right.
Just take female patients.
I'll be the first. What?
I'm sorry.
George.
I'm not sorry. Chest pains.
Chest pains. Now you got two. Need one more.
Brett.
What I've had for a lifetime, a chest cold.
Chest cold. Chest pains, chest cold, chest x-ray. You want to choose one of those?
Yes.
Which one?
X-ray.
Chest x-ray. Now let's find out if chest x-ray is up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and x-ray to ankles first. May we see the $100 number? Chestnut. Chestnut is very good.
Yeah.
Now that I see it, yeah. All right. Let's see if we get a chest x-ray under the $250 number. Chest of drawers.
I threw that out. I figured nobody would ever use that anymore.
Yes. Well, that's strange to get two that not suggested by the celebrities. Last chance here for chest x-ray.
Oh, it has to be.
May we see the $500 number?
Yes. Chest x-ray. You got it. Congratulations.
Very good. You picked up another $500. You're up to $1,800 now. We're going to stop right now and do a little business with America. How do you feel? Here we are with Rory DeMere, who's just won $500 in the first part of the Big Money Super Match, which means she's going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect, you've got to match, remember, one of our celebrities, and this has to be an exact match.
I know.
Okay.
Okay, what?
Okay, what? How do I know? I've never done this before. What do we do now?
Get the bishop.
Give
me
a name or something.
No, you give me a name of one celebrity that you think you could match exactly to collect the $5,000.
I'll try Richard again.
You'll try Richard again. Okay. All right, stand on the tape. Face that way. All right. Okay. She looks so natural, doesn't she? All right. It's worth $5,000, and it goes like this. Blank gum. G-U-M. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but don't say the answers out loud, audience, because your answer may be rotten. And if she hears it... All right. Now, he's made up his mind. We ask you to make up your mind and give us an answer which you think will match his. Blank gum.
Bubble.
Bubble gum. Did you hear them say it out there?
No, I didn't, but I was going to say chewing. I hope he didn't say chewing. I feel awful.
You said bubble gum, right?
Bubble.
Okay.
No, I first thought of chewing.
Well, first thought of chewing.
But I said bubble.
Okay. Bubble it is. Bubble it is. Bubble it is.
Bubble it is.
No?
You were right the first
time. Oh!
Always go. Go with your first instinct.
Yeah, did we tell you to trust your first instinct? That's usually the best one there. Well, listen, Rory, you're still a champ now, remember? We're going to play another game, so let's welcome Apollos Coleman. Hello, Apollos. You know Rory. Now, Apollos, we welcome you, sir, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a native of Los Angeles. I'm single. And at this point in my life, I'm kind of torn between finishing law school and becoming a professional thoroughbred handicapper.
Oh.
For what that's worth.
Well, I missed that, honey.
A professional thoroughbred handicapper, which means...
I love the track.
Yeah. Okay. How many years of law school have you had?
A semester.
One semester?
Yeah.
How many years of track?
Yeah. That's right.
About six.
6 years of track.
I'd go with track if I were you.
Well, now, has the track been good to you?
Comb see, comb side. Goes and comes.
Yeah.
If they're running good.
All right. Well, good luck no matter what you decide here, and good luck here. Apollos, it's up to you to choose A or B.
I'll try B, please.
B it is. New game. Now, I trust everybody in the room here has heard of the Olympic event, the hop, skip, and a jump. Hop, skip, and jump. You know? The guy runs and he hops.
Is that a real Olympic event?
It is a real Olympic event, and it's a very important event. Anyway, there's a new event just for fat people.
Well, don't look at me.
It's called a hop, skip, and blank. That's the new Olympic event for fat people. A hop, skip, and blank.
Oh, let me see now. There really is an event called the Hop, Skip, and the Jump?
Oh, yes.
Why?
Well, I don't know. Some crazy Greek dreamed it up centuries ago, and the tradition hung on.
Hop, skip, and a jump. For fat people, call the
Hop, skip, and blank. Skip. For fat people. Oh, there's a very obvious answer. Fat person.
Is that bad?
No, it's fine. Trust your first instinct.
I got it. Wait a minute. I got to change my answer. Okay.
Oh, you are impossible. Impossible. Hello,
my
Apollos.
Always
How are you?
The Olympic event, hop, skip, and jump. You know about that, right?
Right.
Now, the new event, just for fat people, is called a hop, skip, and...
Fall.
Fall.
Yeah, fall.
Really? How would that apply to a fat person, Apollos?
After the first hop and skip, I doubt if they can jump.
He would fall down after he hopped and skipped.
I couldn't agree with you more. I think the answer is obvious.
Collapse.
Now we've got it, right? You see this? What? See that right there? He went, golly gee whizzikers, he didn't do that. But actually, that was his implication. And I changed mine. To eat.
That's terrible.
Is that worse than fall?
Oh, infinitely worse.
What is the definitive answer?
Well, you'll come to it in a moment or so. Hop, skip, and...
Crawl.
Crawl. Well, that's the same idea as Apollos, which is not a bad idea. What do you say, Donna?
I think I have the definitive answer.
What?
Bounce.
Hop, skip, and bounce is one for a fat person.
Oh, that is all.
That's one.
Dada, isn't she terrific?
Yes, honey.
Very large person, right?
A very large, roly-poly, fat person. Hop, skip,
and roll.
Roll. There's the definitive answer. What do you say?
Well, if it was a really fat person,
yes,
after he hopped and yes, after he skipped,
right,
he would expire.
Expire. Medic!
I like Patty.
Okay, so Paula sets one for you, and you'll have to stand by while we do a little business, and then let's see what we do with you. Watch this. Middle of round one. Shall we carry on, Rory?
Sure.
This is your first round question. Walter said, I come from a really poor family. When our uncle died, we couldn't afford a hearse, so we took him to the cemetery on a blank. We couldn't afford a hearse.
Now, wait a minute, because this is very important.
Yeah.
We couldn't afford a hearse, so we took him to the cemetery on a...
On a blank.
On a...
Right. Good.
Not good.
Yeah, good. Yeah, very good.
I'm not showing you nothing no more, huh?
All right. Atta boy, Charles.
That's nice. Sweet, sweet, touching answer. I like it.
Okay.
Go for it.
Put it in the slot, George, and away we go. Right. Rory, Walter said, I come from a really poor family. When our uncle died, we couldn't afford a hearse, so we took him to the cemetery on a blank.
Stretcher?
On a stretcher.
I don't know.
All right. Well, we'll find out. George, what'd you say?
Rory, it's every bit as good as I gave you. I had a wheelbarrow.
A wheelbarrow.
That's good.
That would be a poor family. What'd you say, Miss Brett?
I said a army cot, or just plain cot, just in case they gave me an argument. But she didn't say cot. She said stretcher.
Right. Which is similar to an army cot, whee! Without legs. And you, Charles?
On a bus.
On a bus is good. I told you it was good. Go ahead, Donna, show them.
All right, I'm the same thing, bus.
That's two buses. Took him to the cemetery in a bus. That good?
I guess.
Oh.
It's better than mine.
Except
if you could change it, what would you say, Rory?
I really have no idea. I'd probably say bus now.
Yeah. None of those appeal to you so far, eh, Rory? Let's see what Richard has. Maybe his will appeal to you.
Was it Uncle Alfred?
Uncle, they didn't name him.
What was his name?
Uncle Fred. You want to call him Alfred? Yeah, we'll call him Uncle Alfred.
Poor devil, we took him on a skateboard.
Skateboard.
Not his fault.
Yeah. He fell off a lot, didn't he? What did you say?
I said they took him on the subway for half fare.
Subway for half fare. The subway for half fare, Brett. Okay, so there we are at the end of round one. Let's see what happens in round two. Apollos.
I'll try B this time.
B. You said B, Apollos.
Yeah,
B. Oopla, George does not play. At the nudist camp, Apollos, they had a terrible problem with insects. So Harvey hung a no-pest strip on his blank. At the nudist camp, they had a terrible problem with insects, so Harvey hung a no-pest strip on his blank.
Whizzikers.
Okay. You don't write.
I'm playing the game just
all right, just practice. Because it's a funny question. All right. Everybody ready over there? All right. Here we go, Apollos. At the nudist camp, Apollos, they had a terrible problem with insects, so Harvey hung a no-pest strip on his...
Can we have a commercial break?
No, Apollos.
Okay.
Think carefully now before you speak.
On his ear.
On his ear. Okay, Listen here, Brett, what do you say?
Honey, I'm sorry. I sit on his bun.
On his bun. Charles?
On his derriere.
On his derriere. All right, Donna?
Well, I meant the same thing.
Back door. All right. He's looking for an ear. What do you say?
Derriere.
Patty?
On his wife.
On his wife. So there we are. Now we got to stop right here and do a little business. America, pay attention. We have come to the end of another day, and we hope you'll be able to join us tomorrow, the next day, whatever day that is. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Whatever day tomorrow is, you will all show up. That's an order, and you must obey orders.
Yes.
Is everything under control?
Do you know that a cab driver, I left a pair of gloves. I want to thank that man. I left a pair of gloves in a cab in New York City, and he returned them to the theater and left them for me.
That was very
kind. I don't want another unkind word said about Manhattan.
Okay, that's it for today. Gene Rayburn, join us next time for Match Day 76.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.